Rinse your cheesecloth in juice. Try to remove as many bits of food as you can. The faster you get to rinsing the cheesecloth, the easier it will be to get food and stains out of it. If you don't have time to rinse it thoroughly right away, put it in a bowl of hot water to soak until you can wash it. Soak the cheesecloth in a removed tough debris. If your cheesecloth has bits of food or stains that are difficult to get out with just hot water, add baking soda to a hot water soak. Use 1/2 cup, 90 grams, baking soda per 1 gallon, 3.75 liters, of water. Leave the cheesecloth in the solution for 10-30 minutes, depending on how severe the stains are. Rinse the cheesecloth thoroughly after you soak it. Add white vinegar or lemon to fade stains and debris. If you have extra stubborn debris or stains on the cheesecloth, add a stain-fighting ingredient to your baking soda soak solution. Simply add 1/4 cup, 59 milliliters, of white vinegar or lemon juice per 1 gallon, 3.75 liters, of hot water along with the baking soda before you soak the cheesecloth. Boil the cheesecloth for ferilization. Bring a large pot of water to boil. Place your cheesecloth inside and let it boil for at least 5 minutes. This will kill any lingering bacteria that may be left in the cheesecloth. It's a good idea to boil the cheesecloth every time after you use it, whether you've just rinsed it or if you've soaked it to get rid of stubborn debris. Rinse the cheesecloth before food debris. Run the cheesecloth under hot water immediately after you use it so the food stains don't set into the cloth. Hang it to dry until you are ready to put it in the washing machine. It's best not to put wet cheesecloth pieces in the laundry basket because it can encourage mold growth. Wash high quality cheesecloth. If you have a cheesecloth that's designed for reuse and made from a high quality knit material, like cotton, you can wash it with other kitchen cloths. Use a detergent meant for delicate fabrics. It should be free of dyes or perfumes, which could damage the cheesecloth or leach out into your food. Use warm or hot water in the wash and a cold water rinse with bleach. Avoid using a fabric softener when cleaning your cheesecloth. The extra fragrance and softening agents will leave a coating on your cheesecloth and can leach into your food the next time you use it. Cheesecloth that's labeled single use cannot be washed in the washing machine. You may be able to hand wash it and reuse once or twice, but it's better to buy cheesecloth meant for reuse. Launder muslin with other If you use muslin as an extra sturdy cheesecloth alternative, you can easily wash it in your washing machine. Add it in the same load with your kitchen or bath towels. Check the label on your detergent to make sure it doesn't contain dyes or fragrances that could contaminate your food the next time you use the muslin. Avoid using fabric softener for your muslin, as it could cause buildup on the cloth that can leach into your food. The muslin will shrink after you wash it the first time. Pick a lightweight unbleached muslin as an easy to clean cheesecloth alternative. Unbleached muslin will have a natural cream color. Find muslin at your local fabric store. Tell them you are looking for muslin to use as cheesecloth for straining or squeezing. Dry the cheesecloth in the drum. After you've washed your cheesecloth by hand or in the washing machine, put it through a hot cycle in the dryer. You can also dry it outside in the sun if it's hot outside and it can dry quickly. Hang it on a clothesline or drape it over a clean chair in direct sunlight. Fold and store the cheesecloth. When the cheesecloth is completely dry, fold it 2 or 3 times until it forms a small square or rectangle. Store it in a cool, dry place in an airtight plastic bag until you are ready to use it again. Reuse sterilized cheese. It's natural that cheesecloth will get stained sooner or later. If the stain doesn't wash out in the laundry, it won't leach out into your food, either. Be sure to sterilize the cheesecloth by boiling it after you hand wash it or launder it in the washing machine. Dry the cheesecloth before you store it. If the stains really bother you, add bleach to your soak water the next time you wash the cheesecloth. Use 1/4 cup, 59 milliliters, bleach per 1 gallon, 1.75 liters, water, 5 liters, water,